Hi friends, welcome to English classes. Today we are going to discuss about present continuous tense and Jijo Abraham. So I have a request, those who haven't subscribed our channel yet, please subscribe it and enable the bell icon that you may get the future videos that we do. Let's start the class. Today we have to discuss about present continuous. So let's start with the situation. Anne is in her car. She is on her way to work. She is driving to work. So now she is driving, and the present situation is stated with the help of present continuous tense. She is driving to work. That means along with that subjects, that means we need to discuss the use of auxiliaries too. Is, am, are. These are the auxiliaries, helping verbs used in this tense. They are added with ing form. That means present participle form. Okay, so let's see the structure. With I, usually we use am. I am driving, I am working, I am doing, etc. If the subject is he, she, it, or the singular subject, along with that we use is. He is driving, she is driving, it is working, it is doing, something like that. If it is we are doing, you are doing, they are driving, etc. If you want to make the negative of these sentences, you can add not in between am or is are and the main verb. That means I am driving, I am not driving, he is driving, he is not driving, we are driving, we are not driving, or we aren't driving, she isn't driving. That is the shortest form while we speak. Then when we take the questions, if we want to make the questions, we can add this is, am, are in front of the subject, then the sentence changes to a question. Then I am driving, am I driving, she is driving, is she driving, we are doing, are we doing. This is the easy way to make the questions and negatives. So let's go with I'm doing something. That means when I make the same statement, by the time I am in the middle of doing something, I have started doing it and I haven't finished it yet. So far it is not completed, it's going on. So usually we can see that present continuous tense is used to say about the things that are happening in and around, as well as the things that are happening at the time of speaking, or the things that are happening that are exactly not at the time of speaking but around, in and around the present time where we live. So these are the three uses. Let's see the first one, the things that are happening at the time of speaking. Please don't make so much noise. I am working. That means at present, when I speak, by the time I am working. That's why just ask to be quiet. Where is Margaret? She is having a bath. At present, she is taking a bath. Then let's go out now. It's raining. It isn't raining anymore. Now it is not raining. That's what is the meaning. Then when you are in a party, hello Jane, are you enjoying the party? That means you are making a question about the present situation. So if you want to make the question that, if you ask the question that do you enjoy the party, that means you are asking about the things in general. That means generally, do you love, do you like, or do you enjoy the party? That is used in simple present tense. It is wrong to say that when you are in a party, by the time you cannot ask a person that do you enjoy the party. It is better to be asked like that. Are you enjoying the party? That means at present you are enjoying the party. Then I'm tired. I'm going to bed now. That is also stated about the present condition that is happening at the time of speaking. Then sometimes that action may not be happening at the time of speaking, or necessarily happening at the time of speaking can be said in present continuous tense that we have seen. The next one, it may not be happening. For example, Tom and Anne are talking in a cafe. Tom says, I'm reading an interesting book at the moment. I'll lend it to you when I have finished it. But at the same time, now he is in a cafeteria and he is not reading anything, but he speaks or he says that I am reading. That means it is stated about the things that are happening at the time. It is not about the things that are happening at the time of speaking, but it says about the present time. That means the present where he lives. Next one, we can see two examples are given. Catherine wants to work in Italy, so she is learning Italian. At the time of speaking, she may be along with us in the same cafeteria, but it is not necessary that she should be reading or she should be learning Italian, being in a hotel or being in a restaurant, etc. So now he is enjoying her food, and at present she is learning Italian. Then some friends of mine are building their own house. So some of my friends, they are building. That means, suppose you are talking the same statement at a night. So usually at night, no work is going on. But then too, it is stated that they are building. That means it is not about the exact time of speaking, but it says about the present time. We use simple present, the present continuous when we talk about things happening in a period around now. That means today, this week, this evening, etc. You are working hard today. Yes, I have a lot to do. That means it is stated about the present condition today. Then, is Susan working this week? So that is asked about this particular week. So it may not be that today Susan may be absent, but at the same time, whether she is doing her work this week, that's what is the question. We use present continuous tense when we talk about the changes happening around now. That population of the world is rising very fast. That is stated about the present scenario, but it may not be happening in front of our eyes. Is your English getting better? So it doesn't happen within a moment, so or within a week or within a month. So it takes time. So that's why we can see that it is stated about the condition. That means at present, whether you are doing something to help yourself to improve your English. This is what the question. So this is the end of the class. Thank you for watching this video. I would like to wish you an amazing day. Thank you.